Here is a unique opportunity to take a peek behind the scenes at the Atlanta Opera. This series of short videos highlights the unsung heroes and heroines of our opera company. Those individuals that create the visual images we see on stage in the final production. Our series begins inside the Atlanta Opera costume shop.
I'm Pat McMahon, I'm the costume shop manager. My job is to make sure that everybody has what they need to get the job done.
My name is Joanna Schwenk, I am the costume designer coordinator for the Atlanta Opera, and I've been here quite a few years. I'm the creative end of the costume. I actually visually put it creatively together.
I'm Cynthia Cochran. I've been working for the Opera since 2004. Everything from the mending of the garments to the alterations that need to be done to even building costumes.
My name is Melinda Brown. I've been with the Opera for about 7 months now. I work in the costume shop as a stitcher, and I also do some wardrobe work in the theater. Joanna Schmink, our costume coordinator, goes up to Malabar Costume Company in Toronto, picks out the package for the show.
The director spoke to me about a month and a half ago and told me his specific desires as far as the visual element of costume goes for the show. And then my responsibility is to go to Malabar and look through their enormous stock of Dutchman pieces and pull together more of a unique quality for this particular production.
Then Malabar has them cleaned, packaged, and sent to us in numbered boxes, and we unpack them. We're working on the Flying Dutchman. We had 15 boxes, which is a pretty minimum kind of show. The last show we had 45 boxes. We record everything that's in those boxes on an inventory sheet to make sure we have everything there and that we can check them on in and out for the production. Usually all costumes need some sort of stitching. A lot of the costumes that we get have been around for many years and they need some repairs, or they've come from another show where that shop has taken the costumes in or out and we need to fix them to fit the performers. We have fitting sessions with all of the performers, and after the fittings we'll get all of the alterations done.
One of the costumes being made especially for is our Dutchman. What they had available was not suitable for our particular singer, so they're making us a brand new Dutchman, which is nice because even though it will pretty much follow the lines of their other Dutchman costumes, the fabrics and the quality will be a little bit different.
This is the Senta costume. She'll be wearing this dress with a great petticoat underneath because she needs some fullness under her dress. We're gonna fit it on the performer and see what needs to be taken in, and we will do the alterations in the costume shop.
After Senta jumps off the cliff going after the Dutchman, comes back, body is washed up on shore. So we can't use the real costume, we have to make a double of that costume and then distress it so that it looks as if she's been hurled around in the ocean.
This is another principal costume. This is Eric, who is Senta's love interest until she rejects him for the Dutchman. It's a kind of fun thing. It's a little more colorful than some of the other costumes, but has this sort of wonderful vest that has purple and green stripes in it. And it's got a lot of interest because it's got a plaid vest and a print scarf and a wonderful kind of colored jacket.
Dutchman is particularly considered a darker color palette as far as costumes go. So the challenge was to find patterns and prints and colors that still have a muted tone, so they're not bright, you know, bright canary yellow, but give us a little bit more variety with either the whole entire costume or accent pieces. Like there's a shawl here that's a little bit more rusty burgundy versus brown. This outfit particular is a gray with a little accent, a little texture, but add on a little pop of color so it takes it up a little level. So we still get an overall muted quality and a darker quality, but it actually adds a little bit more life with a pop of color.
This is the Mary costume. Mary is the older woman who advises Senta and talks to her about the Dutchman and so on. And this is a kind of interest. This costume has a lot of interesting texture in the bodice, even though it's very drab.
Texture is one of those other design elements that I love to use on stage because it gives more variety and is actually more interesting. And if you notice, the quality of the fabric itself is a texture. The men's look for this show, just in variety, overall costuming is more of a uniform look. So to get more variety, we kind of mix the typical sweater and peacoat with more short sleeve vest combinations to get in pops of color for neckerchiefs, as well as changing some of their pants from the dark kind of browns and blacks and grays to add a little extra color as well. Infinitely more of a challenge because there are fewer pieces in the menswear to change around.
This is one of my favorite costumes. This is one of the ghosts. It kind of reminds me of Pirates of the Caribbean with all the leather building. And it has all these really great details of faux leather moments that have been painted to look very grungy and old.
Leave it under lights, these will look almost wet. And then we have combinations of this with other kind of ragtag parts and pieces to make the ghosts seem as if they're from a different time period than the rest of the show.
And when the show is all over and it's all done, and we move out of the theater, we have to pack everything up and send it all back to Malabar.